My name is Alex Hattie. I'm a freshman, and I'm a computer science major, and I love the Rubik's Cube. It's really fun. So. Well, it started when I was in seventh grade, and I just basically remember I had just a really old, like, beaten up Rubik's Cube, and I wanted to know how to solve it. And at first, I really struggled with it, but then as I learned how to do it, then it became easier and easier, and I think I learned how to solve it within, like, a week or maybe 2 weeks, but yeah. I've been to 3 competitions so far, and 2 of them I competed. The first one was in Astoria, Oregon, and that was really fun. It was like the first one in Oregon. And then the second one was actually in Las Vegas. I went to the World Competition in Las Vegas, and that was really, really, really special experience because I got to see like people from Europe and people from Australia. I think there was someone from India. It was just really like a worldwide thing. And then recently there was the U.S. Nationals, and that was in Portland. I did pretty well, I would say, but not, you know, like it's really, really hard to place in the competitions, like if you get like 10 seconds or something like that. But I remember in Las Vegas I got a 20-second solve, and I think my average was around 22 or 23 seconds. That was like an average of 5, so for the regular Rubik's Cube. You memorize a set of moves, and it's like you use the letters F for front, D for down, U for up, B for back, L for left, and R for right, and that's like the faces. And then you do either like L or L prime or like R or R prime, and that just tells you if you move it clockwise or counterclockwise. So like an example of an algorithm would be like R prime, D prime, R D, and with that you move the right face counterclockwise, the down face counterclockwise, right face clockwise, down face clockwise. So in the summer between my 9th grade and 10th grade year, I got back into the Rubik's Cube a lot, and I memorized several algorithms to get to learn the advanced method for this, because to get like under a minute or under about 30 seconds, you have to do the advanced method. So I spent like a month learning like 120 different algorithms. It takes a long time, but it's really easy to do like when you have free time, like just have a sheet of paper and just look at it. And I don't know, I'm really good at memorizing like numbers and letters, so I guess it kind of comes a little easier for me, so maybe it's like something I can do in my spare time, but I don't know.